Welcome back to Let's Read Dread. Today's episode, Mega City 1, 2099. At Justice Central, top lawman Judge Dredd is catching up on a backlog of case reports.
Sorry, sir, you can't go in there. That's Judge Dredd's private office. Hey, put a sock in it! Skin face, Judge Don Oogie, don't take no orders from nobody! From nobody. Sorry. I got one thing to say to you, Dredd. Nuts!
Don Oogie Apeland and his henchmen, Fast Eek and Joe Bananas, the Ape Gang. Cause sure, why the fuck not? Oogie leapt up onto Dredd's desk.
The East Side Mob is muscling in on our territory and you're turning a blind eye. Well, I want it stopped, or Dredd, there's gonna be trouble, see? You tell him, Don Oogie. These skin-faced creeps must think we just cut down from the trees or something.
As far as I'm concerned, you and the East Side Mob are just the same cheap hyper-hoods. One step out of line and I'll come down on you hard.
So that's the way it is, eh? Well, you mark my words, them East Side punks mess with Don Oogie and they get a one-way ride to the morgue.
Yeah, the streets is gonna be running red and it ain't gonna be with ketchup.
When the ape hoods had gone, Dredd pondered the problem after the Great Holocaust. After the Great Holocaust, only zoo animals survived. As time passed, it became possible to alter the brain cells of apes and give them the ability to speak. What could possibly go wrong? Then, one by one, they were allowed freedom.
Apes are great mimics. It was only to be expected some of them would imitate criminals.
Days later, Mega City was rocked by a gang war, which began when Don Oogie's hoodlums raided an East Side Mob nightclub.
Give it a works, boys! Try the refreshing taste of a hair and knuckle sandwich, skin face!
These followed an attack on the Ape Gang Garage. The Grunt Brothers' swinging days were over.
I guess they got shot. I guess. Is that like a flying car shooting at them?
The Ape Gang struck back hard. Sonny Cosmo, number two in the East Side Mob, got a new pair of boots.
That's a real nice fit, Sonny. And concrete takes a good shine, too.
No, no!
Pity no one's gonna see him where you're going.
Eek, eek.
On the fourth day of the gangland war, Dredd drove into the district where all the freed had settled. The jungle.
Rundown houses, garbage everywhere, apes have filthy habits. Nothing will ever clean up this jungle. Well, nothing will clean up the jungle, but cleaning up Don Oogie's hoodlums would sure make the place smell a lot sweeter.
With difficulty, Dredd climbed the ape staircase.
Everyone's afraid to give evidence against gangs, but we've got to catch them red-handed. And the one ape that helps us lives up here, up there. Ma Apeland, Don Oogie's mother.
And so...
What's you talking about, Judge? Ma Oogie, he a good ape. He not do bad things, you say.
Apparently she's Indian now.
He not do the bad things that you say, Judge.
Sorry, I don't know what the hell's wrong with me.
What you talking about, Judge? My Huggy, he a good ape. He no do bad things, you say.
You know Huggy's a vicious hoodlum, Ma. Mama, and you're going to give me some information on him.
Acting on Mama Apelino's information, the judges intercept an East Side mob convoy carrying illegal tobacco into the city. Judges!
Pull over, lawbreakers! Or lawbreaker!
It's a heist! Truck it!
Dredd burst into the cab of the leading vehicle.
Pull over, I said.
The convoy was soon overpowered.
Take them downtown and book them.
Oh, wait, that's not Dredd.
Take them downtown and book them.
The rest of you get into your places. We've still got a gang to deal with.
Soon, in an empty warehouse on the east side. Here they come, boss.
Okay, you apes. Okay, you apes. You know the plan. We let them skin-faced punks drive in, and then we put them. Then we put them to sleep with these Tommy guns. What the heck? Them creeps is speeding up. Eek!
Grunt. I don't know what the grunt is supposed to sound like.
Freeze, you ape hoods!
It's the heat! Whack 'em out!
Oh my god. That just sounds so wrong. Whack 'em out.
Woo! It's the heat! Whack 'em out! Get 'em!
No more monkey business for you, Fast Eek.
But as the judges gain the upper hand, look, Judge Dredd, Don Huggy's trying to make a break for it along the lifting chains. Dredd fired his lawgiver pistol and,
I'm falling!
Luckily, Huggy landed on his feet.
Your days of crime are over, ape.
That's where you're wrong, Dredd. Your criminal laws only cover humans. They don't say nothing about apes. You can't touch me.
There is one law. Maybe you second-generation free apes don't remember it, but your mama did. And thanks to her, I'm going to be putting you where you belong. Behind bars.
The Animal Nuisance Act, 1987, states that any animal creating danger to human life must be kept in a secure place. There was no more secure place than Don Huggy's ancestral home, the Mega City Zoo.
That was just like a stupid old gangster. Listen, punk, stop making with the wisecracks. Give me that stinky banana.
Oh, boy. And signs for muties, gleeps, monkeys, and something else. Yeah, that sounds friendly.
Have some more tea, Fast Eek. Hey, what you doing, you big ape? Sheesh, a couple more years of this is enough to make any ape go straight.
New adventure, next Prague. One planet, one comic, 2000 AD.
Okay, well that's it for today. I hope you had fun, and we'll see you next time on Let's Read Dredd.
Hey, the Alchemist sailed. Your ass was waiting for air. Love!